benefit both the Cambodian government, the Cambodian people, and our organization if we're able to make an MOU. Because I have partners in America that have one organization. They in 1 year they raised $20 million. So currently that organization, they're called Living Water International. They're working in Africa, Central South America. They're working in Haiti and also in India, but they're not yet working in Southeast Asia. I've already met with the CEO and the senior vice presidents of that organization, and I've talked with them about the CEO and the senior vice president, and I'll be able to tell them, I will ask them to please station in Cambodia. This would greatly benefit my abilities and my efficiency to bring clean water to Cambodian people. My own house, everything that I have is in Cambodia. Our filter distribution, and also we make soap that we can distribute to students.
We welcome for your project and we please support what you are doing in Cambodia. Next time we can consider the proposal. You try to get one try and learn more Cambodian and then you can. Let's try to mobilize as fast as possible funds from US, from Korea, and maybe helping housing for the poor people is very much for the spirit of the Buddha to help poor people.
Yeah, so we built more than 130 homes for poor families. We drilled water wells at more than 50 schools. So for me, I feel like we're just starting. And I feel like our efficiency and our volume will increase as our ability increases.
Kong Chhay is my hometown, so that's why he invited you to help the poor people there.
Absolutely.
Because the leprosy is one of the story that I was seeing, I was Xinjiang in that province. So we need to find out how we can terminate this leprosy contamination in this community. And this community is very poor, and communication to neighboring is very hard because the people fear leprosy.
Right.
So before we have one of the story that one of the company that doing rock business in their village, in their community, and they don't allow the leprosy patient or the community people they doing their job because they're feeling contamination. So when I went there, then I stopped the company and we let the people living in the community working in this because those people is very poor. They eating the rock, you know, and get it
set so for gravity.
So I talked with the company, if you want to do the rock business, you can do that. But you stop machinery and let the people working and you can buy the rock from the community. So that one can help the living standard of the people in
that community.
Actually, for the Ministry of Health, working with NGO, how can we find a way to stop the leprosy contamination in that
community?
As they come back to their community. In the Khmer Rouge, we are living in all together in the labor camp. You know? So we work all together, and nobody consider their camp from you know, the leprosy community or not.
One, two, three.